We want to solve the absolute value inequalities. We want to express the solution as a compound inequality, a graph, and using interval notation. And we'll start with two basic absolute value inequalities to get an idea of how these types of problems work. Here we have the absolute value of x is less than 4. Remember, absolute value is a number's distance from 0. So here we're looking for all the numbers that have a distance from 0 that is less than 4 units. And then for the second example, we have the absolute value of x is greater than 4. So here we're looking for all the numbers that have a distance from 0 that's greater than 4 units. To get a better idea of how this works, let's take a look at a Wolfram demonstration. Here's the graph of the absolute value of x is less than 4. Notice how all the numbers that have a distance from 0 that's less than 4 units has been shaded. What I want you to recognize here that to write this as an inequality not containing an absolute value, this would require the intersection of two inequalities. We would have x is less than 4 and x is greater than negative 4. So it would be two inequalities connected by the word and if the original inequality symbol is less than. And if it's less than or equal to, it's almost the exact same graph except notice how now it includes the endpoints. So if I change the value of 4, of course it's going to change the graph, but the idea is exactly the same. And if I change this to the absolute value of x is greater than 4, notice how now in blue, all the numbers that have a distance from 0 greater than 4 units have now been graphed. And this is going to be the union of two inequalities, where here we have x is greater than 4, or x can also be less than negative 4. So if we have an absolute value inequality where the original inequality symbol is greater than, we'll have two inequalities connected with or. And again, if I change this to greater than or equal to, the only difference is it's going to change the endpoints. So let's go back and take a look at our two examples. For the absolute value of x less than 4, we're going to have a compound inequality connected by the word and, so we'll have the intersection of two inequalities. The first inequality is going to be x is less than 4. So notice for the first inequality, we just drop the absolute value. And for the second inequality, we're also going to drop the absolute value, but we're also going to make two additional changes. We're going to reverse the inequality symbol, so it's going to be greater than, and then change the sign of the 4, so we'll have greater than negative 4. The intersection of these two inequalities will give us the graph of the absolute value of x is less than 4, meaning all the numbers on the number line that have a distance from 0 less than 4. So for x less than 4, I have an open point on 4, arrow to the left. And then for x greater than negative 4, we'll have an open point on negative 4 and an arrow to the right. Now we can't leave our graph like this. Because this compound inequality is an and, we're looking for the intersection of these two intervals, which means the interval where the values are graphed twice, and we can see it's going to be the numbers in between negative 4 and 4. So let's go ahead and adjust our graph to only include the interval between negative 4 and 4. And now to express this using interval notation, notice we have an open interval from negative 4 to 4, meaning it does not include the endpoints. So we have a rounded parenthesis on negative 4 as well as positive 4. Now for the second example, we have the absolute value of x greater than 4. So now the two inequalities will be connected by the word or. So we'll have the union of two inequalities, where the first inequality, again, we're just going to drop the absolute value. So we'll have x is greater than 4 or. And then for the second inequality, we drop the absolute value, reverse the inequality symbol, and change the sign of the 4. So we have x is less than negative 4. Now let's go ahead and graph these. We have x greater than 4, open point on 4, arrow to the right, or x is less than negative 4, so we have an open point on negative 4, an arrow to the left. And now to express this using interval notation, as we move right on the number line, we're approaching positive infinity. And as we move left, we're approaching negative infinity. Therefore, using interval notation, we have negative infinity and negative 4 in parentheses. Again, this parenthesis here shows negative 4 is not included, or here we have from 4 to infinity, again in parentheses. So now we've expressed the solution as a graph, as a compound inequality, and using interval notation. Now there's one more thing I do want to mention. Sometimes instead of using the word and, you'll see the use of the intersection symbol instead, which looks like an upside down U like this. And sometimes instead of using the word or, you'll see texts use U for union, but they do mean the same thing. Here we looked at two basic examples of absolute value inequalities. We'll take a look at some additional examples in the next several videos.